My name is Addy, and I came to planet Earth with many of you to assist the process of planetary ascension. We call it ascension, but really it is the planet shifting. The planet is restoring her balance. What she is really doing is that within the Earth is what we would call the Tree of Life. This Tree of Life is the axis of the Earth. Some could call it the Axis Mundi. The Axis Mundi is an alignment of the Earth with the rest of heavens, and that would mean with the rest of the cosmic web of life. The Earth suffered in the past a major misalignment of this axis, and in our terms that would mean that the Earth became tilted. The Tree of Life became tilted. And when that Tree of Life becomes tilted within the Earth, all life becomes misaligned. Now, we have been living in a misaligned reality. And the goal of this process that we call ascension is really the realignment of this Axis Mundi within the Earth, so that the Earth again can be part of the collective of cosmic web of life. This is very important. This is why humans had that feeling that was pretty real, that we are alone in this field of creation, while there are zillions of other beings and places and worlds and dimensions. So this disconnect was really important in some way, because humanity was using life force to create things that life force was really not intended to be used for. Life force, when you look at the entire cosmos, seems like the rainbow serpent of creation. And this rainbow light is source light. You can call it the mother's milk. Something that nurtures the baby, the reality to be created. So without life force, there are no worlds, there is no reality, and there is no you and me, there are actually no beings. All of creation is fueled by life force. That, what we call free will, is the will of a being, and not only a will, but really the consciousness of a being, to either use all of life force constructively to create more beauty, more perfection, more harmony, more love, more creativity, more expansion, to be more innovative, or to use that life force without consciousness. It is comparable to how, let's say, as a parent, if you had a child or if you have a child, let's say every morning you give your child $1 million. As a parent, you would hope that your child will spend that kind of life force constructively. And you would hope that your child will just completely 100% use that investment in ways that benefit the child and the world. If your child spends even a fraction of that wealth on something that is destructive, you will not like it as a parent, because you will be concerned for your child. Let's say in this world we are familiar with the concept of drugs that can destroy lives. Let's say heroin. If you have a child that you give $1 million every morning and you say, go and use this wealth of life force, and your child will take even a small fraction and spend it on heroin, whatever drug that destroys lives, you as a parent will not want to repeat the same ritual the next morning. You will not want to give the same amount to that child the next day. And you might decide that if your child is using any part of life force, in our case money, in this really destructive way, that you will cut off that supply. And that is what happened on planet Earth. We were, and we still are in this very moment, children who were using supply of life force in a way that did not serve greatness, and it was not used consciously. And so we had to be cut off from that supply. This supply is also what we would call divine feminine. It is really like the divine mother tells us, divine mother's milk. And so divine mother's milk cannot be used to produce something that destroys life. It is like destroying your own mother. And if you have a good relationship with your mother, you know what it's like to love your mother. Not everyone has that, but that again is part of the distortion. Ideally, as children of light, we receive the fullness of our divine mother's life force, and we mix it in our sacred hearts with our own desire to create something very special, something that we can be proud of, something that serves all life and never harms any part of life, including ourselves or another. In this process of transformation, we are really learning as humanity, as individuals, as a collective, to honor 100% of this wealth and not even a fraction, not even, you know, 0.1% of life force should go wasted. Because why do that? Again, the example with the child. You would never want your child to do that. So creation does have a desire. It does have this intelligence. And we can call the intelligence of creation Christ consciousness. The intelligence of creation only leads one way, just like a river, just like water, water being really the quantum computer of creation. Christ consciousness is information. It is intelligence. It has nothing to do with one being or another being. It is not Jesus. It is not Krishna. It is in us, in all of us. It is in all life. It is the intelligence in all life, where life is intelligent. Intelligence doesn't mean knowledge. Intelligence means knowing. Knowing where the river flows. Knowing that there is only one way, and that way is love. That way is oneness. That way is being one with all that is and serving that in selfless being. And so, as we flow with that intelligence, we flow with Christ consciousness.